this is Richard from XPRO Elementor Addons, and today I'm gonna show you how you can effectively display information with icons, titles, and description in an easy way using the free Elementor Icon Box widget by XPRO.
Icon Box to highlight product features, services, company mission or vision, scales, departments, and much more in a concise manner.
First, make sure to install and activate the free XPRO Elementor plugin. You can find the link in the description box below. And you can also find a video on how to install and activate it on a YouTube channel. So make sure to install and activate it to make amazing videos.
So here you can see this website on which I am working. I have used this icon box to display the services this hotel offers. Let's delete it and remake it from the scratch so you could see the process of how to use the icon box widget in Elementor. The search panel, let's search for an icon box widget and then simply drag and drop it over here. Easy, right? Now comes the fun part, adding content to your icon box widget. Under the content tab, the first thing we have is the media tab. Here you can select an icon or even an image. I'm going to select an icon. You can also upload an SVG that is ideal if you want to resize it freely without the fear of being blurred. In the icon library, we have more than 300 icons including regular, solid, and if you want to go for brand logos, then you can select it from here. I'm going to select a balance icon. Let's search for it. Yeah, this looks good. So title, let's type the title. You can type the name of your product, service, whatever you want. I'm going to type estimated cost. Then we have our description where we give a brief overview of our product or service in an icon box. I'm typing personalized luxury with accurate cost estimates. Next, we have the batch text. It's a great way to highlight key information. Viewers will notice it right away. I'm going to type free. Wow, I think I. Another cool thing is the box link. You can easily add an info link to your icon box widget just by typing the name and selecting it. It will take the viewer directly to your link page. Or you can simply copy the link and paste it over here. Then we have some link settings to explore. You can choose whether you want the link website to open in a new window or not. There's also an option called no follow, which tells search engine not to follow the link. Personally, I won't enable it because I want to maximize the visibility of my website page. Now let's briefly touch on custom attributes. This allows you to assign some key values to perform specific functions like downloading. Moving forward, we have HTML tags. These tags help organize the structure of your web page. The H1 tag is the most important and H6 is the least important. Your search engine will be able to understand the hierarchy and relevance of your content better. I'm selecting H3. Next, we have layout. Here we have two options, inline, where the icon and title come side by side, and block, where the title comes below the icon. I like the block one. Now we have alignment. We can align our icon box either left, center, or right. I like the center as it goes well with my layout.
Alright, we have named the content tab. Let's move to the styling tab.
Here you have full control. You can style however you like without spending a penny and time on designers. Under the style tab, we have icon, title, description, and badge to style for. Let's style the icon first. You can change the size of icon by adjusting the slider like this. Let's try 30. It's a bit small. Let's try 50. Yeah, this looks good. Next is the background size. We can adjust the size of the background from here. It is set to 50 pixels. Adding 10 pixels will make it look better. So 60 pixels it is. Next is the margin, which you can adjust by increasing or decreasing from here. You can also unlink it and set it differently. I only want to have margin from the top. Let's try 60. No, a little less. 55 pixels. Yeah, this looks good. In the border type, we have multiple options to select from, like solid, dotted, dashed. I like the solid one. Next we have is the border width. You can increase or decrease the thickness of the border from here. Next is the border color. I want to have a transparent color as I only want the border to appear during the hover, which we'll discuss it later, don't worry. First, let me show you how the border radius will appear. And for that, I cannot select transparent right now. If I type 0, it will become a square and it will become a bit radial. Then looks good, right? Another thing, if you want to size it differently, you can do it by unlinking from here. This tool gives you full freedom and it's easy, right? Changing it back to 10 pixels. Now let's select a color for the border. You can select the color from here. As I told you before, I'm going to select a transparent color. The next cool option is the box shadow. You can select the color from here. You can make it go horizontally or vertically by adjusting the sliders. And if you want to make it more or less blurry, you can adjust the blurriness here. You can also increase or decrease the border spread around the icon like this. However, I'm only adding 10 pixels to the blurriness because I don't want the other options. Now we have normal and hover options. Let's play with the normal one first. Let's select color for the icon from this color option. I want it to be a bit orange. Yeah, this looks good. In the background type, we can have a classic or gradient. Let's try the classic one first. Now let's try the gradient. Let's select the colors for it. Let's select a bright color, maybe something like this. We can adjust the locations of the color from the slider. We can also select the gradient type from here. We have linear and we can adjust its angle from here. Then we have radial and we can adjust its position from these options. I'm probably not a fan of gradient, so I'm gonna get rid of it. I like the solid one. You can style however you want. Pretty cool, right? We're done with the normal option. Now let's move on to the Elementor icon box hover effect and see its magic. Here we have the color option. I'm going to select white for the icon. And then again we have classic. And then a background color. I'm going to select something orange for the background. Let's hover over the icon. It looks appealing, right? Oh, we forgot to add border color. Let's see it. You can also add gradient for the hover option. Let's select some colors. The hover will appear like this. But as I told you before, I'm not a fan of gradient, so I'm selecting with the solid colors. Cool thing we have is the animation, where we have multiple options like bounce out, fade in, wobble. They're pretty cool, right? Let's try rubber. I like this one, so I'm gonna stick with it. Next, a transition duration. You can make the animation go slower and faster from here, like this. I'm selecting 1 second. That's it for the icon. Let's move to the title now. Under the title, we have typography. Let's play with it. Here, you can choose the font for the title from this font family. We have multiple options like Arial, Verdana, Times New Roman. I'm going to select Open Sans since it is a bit modernized and easy to read. Perfect for the icon box. Next is the size for the title. We can adjust the size of the title by adjusting the sliders. or simply typing the size. Let's try some 10 pixels. It's a bit small. Let's try 20 pixels. Yeah, this is the one. Now let's go for weight. Here we have different weights like 200, 500, 900, 700, 600. I like the 600 one. It's not too bold or light. Next is transform, where we have uppercase, in which all letters are capital, lowercase, opposite of uppercase, capitalize, in which only the first letter of the words are capital. I'm selecting the default. Now we have style, where we have normal, italic, and oblique. The italic and oblique are somewhat similar. Oblique is smoother. I'm selecting default. Next we have decoration, where we have underline, overline, line through. I'm selecting the default. Next we have is the line height. Here we can adjust the height of lines like this. I like the 25 pixels. Next is the letter and word spacing, where we can adjust the space between the words and letters by adjusting the sliders like this. I don't need it, so let's leave it as it is. Then we have text shadow for text. You can adjust it in the same way we did for the icon. I'm only adding 10 pixels to the blur option, keeping it same like the icon. Next is the color for the title. We have the same normal and hover options for the title as well. You can select the color for the title from this color option. I like the black color. It seems sophisticated. Moving on to the hover, let's select the color. Now let's see. Nice, but I don't need it, so resetting it. Next, you can add the margins for the text. I'm going to add margins to the top only. So unlinking it. Let's add some. 10 pixels, no. 15, doesn't feel right. 20 pixels, yeah, 20 looks good. Now we have the description. We have the same option. You can either go with the same style as the title or mix it up by selecting a different color or font. I'm going to change the font to Poppins. Next is the size, changing it to 18. No, too much. 16. This looks good. Now time for the weight. Let's try some. $400 looks good. Keeping the remaining settings same. Now let's try the text shadow for the description. I'm not changing it. I'm keeping it same. Then we have the normal and hover color options. Selecting the normal color. Now let's select the hover color. Oh, pretty, but I only want the hover to be on the icon, so resetting it. Lastly, the margins for the description. I want my description to be in the middle, so I'm unlinking the values to set it accordingly. For the top, I'm adding 10 because I've already added margins to the icon, so adding a little now. For the right, let's try 100. Oh no. 80, still no. 60 looks good. Adding 60 to the left as well. 60 for the bottom. Oh no. Let's try 50. Yeah, this looks good. We're done with the description. And now we're left with the styling of the badge. Let's get it done. In the position, we have multiple options to choose from, like middle center, bottom center, top left. I like the top right. Next is the typography. I'm going to select not Poppins. I'm going to keep it the same as the title one, Open Sans. Next is the size. Let's try some. 10, no, it's too small. 15 looks good. You can displace the badge from its position using the offset. You can either displace it left, right, top, bottom, wherever you want, but I don't need it, so I'm resetting it. Next is the padding, which is the distance between the empty spaces. You can increase or decrease like this. I like negative one. Next, we have color for the button text. We can select color from this color option. I'm selecting white color. It goes well with the icon box. Next is the background color. I want it to be a shade of orange, just like the icon color. We can also add border to the badge from this border options. Then we can increase or decrease the width of the border. We can also change the color of the border from this border color. Then we have a border radius. If I type 10, it becomes a square. And if I type 20, it becomes radial. I like the radial one. However, I do not need a border, so I'm resetting it. Then we have the box shadow, not changing anything. Oh, here we have the position of the shadow. If you want it inside the icon box edges, then select insert. If you want it on the outer edges, then select outline. I like the outline. So we're done with this icon box. Now let's duplicate it and paste it to the remaining columns. Since it is a travel agency, they would be providing travel and hotel services and might arrange some events. So let's try something related to that. I don't want a badge on the wrist. I mean, let's be real. Not everything is for free, right? Now let's select an icon. Let's select a plain icon. This looks good. I'm going to insert it. And for the title, I'm going to write best flights. And let's write a description for it. Moving on to the next icon box, let's select an icon. Let's add a microphone for the events. In the title, I'm going to type local events. And let's write a description for it. I like the other icon, so I'm going to change the microphone. Now let's select an icon for the last icon box. I'm going to type hotel. Let's insert it. In the title, I'm going to write hotel services. Let's write its description. We might add a link to the service in the box link. I want my services to be highlighted from the rest of the website, so I'm going to change the color of the containers. This looks good. I'm going to copy and paste it for the rest of the containers. You know what? I think I should change the size of the icons. It looks a bit bigger. Let's change it to something smaller. Let's try some sizes. Yeah, 38 looks good. Changing for the remaining icon boxes. 38. Yep, now they all look good. That's it. Let's have a look. Oh wow, it looks good.
So this is what you can do with this free amazing widget by XPRO. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more amazing videos.